Jim D with the basket. Trey Gulley from the board. Steal, D. Thomas. Nice job. Too close. Persistence pays off. 20. Michael Dean. Three, Michael Dean. On fire.
Hello, everyone. I'm John Duclos. Welcome to the official 1993 Acton Boxborough Colonial basketball highlight video. The 1992-93 season was an important transition year for the Colonials. We saw a great heart and a great group of athletes. Athletes like Jimmy D, Mike Finn, Greg Robidoux, Jimmy D, Greg Lozier, Matt Chakowski, and oh yes, Eric Vondelin, the 6'6 sophomore. The list goes on and on. How about those cheerleaders who work so hard to bring to the players and spectators that supportive optimism and enthusiasm that is so important in competitive sports today? Let's not forget the tenacity of the players. The early season excitement of John Duclos' shot that propelled Acton into overtime with Bedford. The extraordinary hustle and competitiveness of Colin Brannan, game in and game out, that was to become the trademark of this team. The story begins back in November when the call was issued to begin tryouts. The Colonials were beginning a new season with a new coach, Ron Dunham.
Coach Dunham came from Millbury High School, where he coached for 16 years and compiled an amazing record, including 10 league championships. Now in Acton, he was bringing in a new offensive and defensive philosophy, a completely new program and approach.
I'm looking to create a continuous program here at AB. As coaches, we must always look at what is best for the overall program while developing good people. We will emphasize team basketball as the foundation of a successful program.
Assisting Coach Dunham with managing the overall program was JV coach Rick Kilpatrick and Rob Donaldson, the freshman coach. Many responded to the call for tryouts, but few were chosen. The five juniors selected were John Duclos. Duke was the most valuable player from last year's junior varsity team. He led the JVs in scoring last year with over 12 points per game. John has been called on to play many positions for AB. He's a strong defender and rebounder. He plays hard at both ends of the court. John needs varsity playing experience and has shown that he's a good learner. Look for John to make a solid contribution this year. Matt Chakowski. Matt is another player up from last year's junior varsity team. Matt can provide instant offense. He's a threat outside and inside with his baseline moves. He was the second highest scorer on the JVs last year with just under 12 points per game. He has been working hard on posting up and is improving his defense. Matt is committed to basketball. Greg Robidoux. Chuck is learning how to be a future point guard at AB. He has shown signs of being a good player. He is working hard on his passing and shooting. He always thinks team and is willing to do whatever it takes to be successful. Greg is an honor student and is very coachable. Mike Finn. Huck is a true student of the game. He is usually the last one out of practice. He loves to play and will give his all on and off the court. Mike sees the court well and is working hard on ball handling skills. He is a truly unselfish player who will contribute to the success of this year's team. Michael Lamb. Mike was forced to sit out this season after the team was chosen. He will not be able to play in games or practice due to medical reasons. Last season, he played point guard on the JV team and displayed an accurate shot from the outside. Mike was consequently brought up to varsity where he gained some experience. He is a strong defensive player and would have contributed this year. Mike will be missed this season, but Coach Dunham has called on him to help with practice organization, stats, and team personnel. Mike has a keen sense for the game of basketball. The four sophomores include Eric Vonderlinden. Bondo is the only true center on this year's AB team. He has made great progress with each practice and game because of a great attitude and growing intensity. At this point, Bondo may not know how good he can be. His block shots were intimidating, and his presence gives AB a totally different look. Eric is a big part of AB's future. Jim D. Jim has excellent skills and sees the court very well. He has developed tremendously since last season when he was the quarterback of the freshman squad. He can hit the open man or drive to the hoop. Jim also has become an outside threat from the perimeter. He has been a key man on all AB trap presses. Just as Jim was starting to play well, he was injured with a deep thigh bruise. AB hopes for success are tied to this point guard, D. Thomas. D, one of the best pure athletes on the team, is a player with unlimited potential in basketball. He led the Frost in steals last season. He is unselfish and can be an explosive offensive threat at any time. D has extraordinary quickness and will be a future star. As his game became more controlled, he scored a season high of 28 points against Wesley. AB opponents soon came to know D. Thomas and elected him to the Dual County League All-Star team. Greg Lozier. Greg has been working very hard to become a complete player. He has the tools and desire to be effective in every phase of the game. He has continued to improve since the first day of practice. He has a good outside shot and can become a very effective post-up player with hard work. Greg possesses good basketball sense and is a quiet but tough competitor who will just improve with experience. In this year, characterized by transition, the tri-captains provided that transitional bridge of experience between the old and the new. They all were pivotal parts of last year's team while demonstrating their ability to compete at the varsity level. Michael Dean. Dino is probably the most versatile player on the team. He was the leading scorer and second leading rebounder last season. He also led in a three-point field goal percentage with 42%. He is a three-year starter at forward. Dino will again be called on to score points, but he must play solid defense as well as hit the three-pointer, making him very difficult to defend. He did yeoman's work on the boards this season. Michael will be going to college next fall, but he has not yet picked out a school. He is an honor student and could make some college coach very happy. He would like to major in finance. Dino also was elected to the league's All-Star team. Trey Gulledge. Trey is a gifted athlete with strength and quickness and has been asked to do much more this year. He will have to get his share of rebounds and stop opponents who are bigger in size. He can hit the jumper or take it to the basket, which makes him a very versatile player. This is Trey's third year on varsity. He is also lettered in football and track. An honor student, Trey hopes to attend either Texas University, Baylor, or Rice and major in pre-med. Colin Brennan. Colin, a quiet leader who leads by giving everything he has on the court, is a returning starter at guard, where he was the quarterback in offense last year for AB. He is a great, gutsy, tenacious competitor on defense. Colin has a consistency that coaches like to see. He plays hard all the time. He can be a deadly shooter. He averaged over 6 points per game, including 20 trays last year. Colin will have to hold the team together in the backcourt so that the opponents will be stifled when they try to press AB. Colin is undecided on where to attend college in the fall, but would like to major in political science. James Staples. JB is the best person that a new coach could have. He has been Coach Dunham's eyes and ears at the school. He does not have to be told what to do. He's a valuable practice player, organizer, and an all-around asset to the AB program. He may be called a manager, but he's more like an assistant coach. JB is the scorekeeper for all JV and varsity games as well. Installing a new system and a new philosophy will be difficult enough under normal circumstances, but the job will be more challenging considering the inexperience of the 12-man varsity squad. Leadership will certainly rest on the shoulders of the three seniors, Trey Gulledge, Michael Dean, and Colin Brennan.
These seniors have shown some great leadership qualities so far. They have helped me tremendously in terms of getting to know the other players and implementing some new ideas. These seniors must hold us together during the year.
While the hallmark of the Colonials will clearly be a stingy and aggressive defense, the offense will be more patient. This year's team will choose to work for an inside shot nearer to the basket.
We used a lot of picks and screens. We'll try to take advantage of what we're not given. We want the other team to worry about what we do and keep them off balance. We must make adjustments on defense. We really have to work at it. Good defense must be there for us to be successful, and that means team as well as individual defenses. You may not see the same defense for more than a couple of minutes at a time.
Helping this group of student athletes is a talented and supportive group of young ladies. They too went through a trial period until all was settled and the squad was announced. Then they eagerly went about their business, preparing to usher in the new season. They were to be found after school practicing their routines that would so signify the spirit of the 1992-93 varsity basketball season. Members of this year's varsity... Laura Kwasminen. Colleen Fenton. Jen Zipral. Carol Goller. Michelle Netter. Nancy Roman. Honey Marks. Toby Sparrow. Kristen Douglas. Jessica Shedd. Kelly Spratt. Missy Bowden. Leah Newton. Camilla Gorman. Jerusha Dunham.
The stage is set. The drills, practices, and scrimmages are but a prelude to the emotion and excitement that will be generated on opening night.
Gray Ghosts. It's Tuesday evening, December 15th. This is Westford's first game in the Dual County League, a new addition to the league, and I think going to be a good addition to the league. They've put on a good show here tonight with a jazz band and a good crowd and a concession stand and putting most of the other schools in the Dual County League to shame. Don't know much about Westford. They look to be about the same size as Acton Boxborough. Acton-Boxborough starts three seniors and two sophomores. Returning seniors, Michael Dean, Trey Goage, and Colin Brannon. Both, all three, big contributors to last year's team. Westford Academy is starting five seniors this season. Again, both sides look to be about the same size. Michael Dean will be jumping center for AB. Michael's listed this year at 6'3". Michael's been a three-year varsity player, and at the end of last year was one of the best players in the Dual County League over the last five or six games. Again, Michael Dean jumping center against Mike Moulton from Westford. Also, this is Coach Ron Dunham's first game at Acton Boxborough High School. Mike Moulton gets the tap out of bounds. Blue ball, Acton Boxborough. Man-to-man defense for Westford. Ball to Michael Dean on the outside. Colin Brand. Pretty good man-to-man defense by Westford. Ball over to Dean. Michael Dean. Colin Brand to the basket. Yes! Colin Brand. On the team. Colin Brannon for one. Makes it. Colin Brannon. We even have a game announcer here. I'm very impressed with Westford. Putting on a good show tonight. Man-to-man defense. Excuse me. Looks like matchup zone. Inside Mamos. Trey Gulledge, Demetrius Thomas. For two, Demetrius Thomas. 5-0 Colonials. Touch foul. Thomas out up top, Brandon and D. On the wings, Dean and Gulledge underneath. 1-2-2. Inside, nice move. Jim D guarded by number 23, Paul Davison. Trey Gulledge from the outside. Yes, Gulledge for two. Turnover, Acton Boxborough ball, 7-0, 14:01 to go. Out of bounds, 7-2, AB over Westford. Brandon, Trey Gulledge, loses it. Ball's picked up. 33, Joe Werner, over to Paul Davison. 25, Mark Policio. Ball's over to number 52, Stamos. On the ground, got to get dirty. Nice rebound, Michael Dean. Werner, 7-6. Both teams have enjoyed a run. Foul. 23, excuse me, Paul Davison. Brandon makes the second. 5 points for Colin Brandon. Half court. Man to man to carry. Didn't call it. Three. 25, Mark Popolicio. Michael Dean misses it. Offensive foul, number 33. Joe Werner. Nice play, Colin Brandon. Took the charge, 9-9. 11:08 to go. Jim D. Half court pressure by Westford. Colin Brandon. Ball's over to Dean. Demetrius Thomas. Up. Yes! Demetrius Thomas.
Over Westford.
Ball open, wide open. Missed it. Popolicio. Guy likes to say that guy's name. 11-11. Steal. Fouls on D. Nice steal. 11 up. 11-11. 10:25 to go in the first half. Colonials got off to a nice start, up 7-0. Westford came back with their own run of 6 in a row. We're tied now, 11-11, with 10:25 to go. Haven't been able to get Michael Dean into the game yet. A lot of turnovers. Michael Dean, charge. No. Michael Dean with a big rebound there. Matt Chakowski up in the air, rebound Brandon. 7 points for Collin, 14-13. Westford Academy over Acton Boxborough. 1-2-2 zone. Nice play. Rebound, Michael Dean. It's a foul, number 33. 1-2-2 zone again, looks like, for Westford. Gotta move it quicker. Gotta move it quicker. Nice play, Collin. Collin Brandon underneath. 15-14, AB over Westford. Nice move, Jim D. Nice move. Didn't finish it off, though. Short. Nice going. Good hustle, everybody. Whoa! Three. Come on, take him. Demetrius Thomas. Tied up again. 22 up. Hit the ground really hard. 26-24, 1:19 to go. Jim D. We'll see, just blow by him. Collin Brandon makes the first. Collin's having a nice night at the line. 28-25. Collin Brandon back in of a 1-1 of a 2-shot. Makes them both. 2, 4, 6, 8. 8 foul shots for Brandon, keeping him in the game. 28-26. Demetrius Thomas with the hustle play. Collin Brandon back to Thomas for three. Almost. Good try. Hustle back. Steal. Michael Dean in the middle. Demetrius Thomas short. Academy, 28, Acton Boxborough, 27. Stand by for second half action. Brandon fouls out with 18 points, 18 of the 33 this evening. 1:48 to go. Westford just cleared their bench. Mike Corrado. Lane violation, Acton Boxborough. Even the subs are hustling here. Foul. Foul's number 52. Greg Lozer, his first. Two.
Cleveland 42. At the line. Shooting 1-1. Missed it. Block. Another block. Von der Linden. Couple of sophomores. Over, out of bounds. Marchand on the board, in the book. 59-33. Greg Robidoux over to Greg Loser from outside, off the back rim. Foul. Gulledge makes it.
Good evening, this is John Martin from Acton Boxborough Regional High School, and welcome to Acton Boxborough Basketball. We're here for the boys' basketball game between the Bedford Buccaneers and the Acton Boxborough Colonials. It's Friday evening, December 18th. Second game of the year for both teams. Both teams are 0-1. Bedford lost a tough one to Whalen. Acton Boxborough lost one at Western the other night. Michael Dean, jumping center against Chris Midget. Ball to John Duclos. Colin Brandon for two. Colonials got out to a pretty good lead the last game, 7-0 against Western, but had just a terrible second half. Only way to describe it. They had outscored, I believe it was 33-9 the second half of the game against Western after only being down by one at halftime. Bedford was up most of the way against Whalen, and Whalen came back to win. Jared Carlson, first two for the game, 9-3. Nice pass, Michael Dean, Trey Gulledge. Quick up, nice job. 11-5. Fouls, basket. John Duclos. Nice look, John Duclos. Zone defense, Colonials.
Thomas, yes! Thomas is 2 for 2. Colonials up by 9. Get over. Michael Dean. Yes, for 3. Michael Dean, 7 points for Michael Dean. Looks like a completely different player tonight. Really confident. 22. Push off. Come on. Nice pass, John Duclos. Yes! Skullage!
Nice rebound. John Duclos. Jim D. Long. Michael Dean, rebound.
Yes, Michael Dean! 26-14. Ball's off to Michael Dean. Michael Dean! Taking charge, 28-14.
Come on, up, defense. Don't reach.
Come on, doing everything right except the reach. 5:42 to go. 28-14, fouls on Matt Joukowsky.
Behind you. Joukowsky.
Yes. 3, Matt Joukowsky. Michael Dean for 3. Yes. Michael Dean for 3. 40-19. Double them up.
Inbounds.
Inbound here for the second half. Same starting lineups for both teams. AB, Colin Brannon, John Duclos. Michael Dean. Basket, Colin Brannon. 42-35. That's a foul. Basket, Joukowsky.
5 to go.
Colonials again only scored 4 points in the first 8 minutes of the second half. Colin Brannon among the trees. Big basket, Colin Brannon. Yes, Michael Dean. Great play by Michael Dean. Colonials down by 1. 3:40 to go. Nice dish off, Gullidge to Thomas. Down by 2. Nice job, Trey Gullidge. Yo, come on, defense, little defense. Some position to do something with it. 1:20 to go. D. Come on, Michael, do something. Michael Dean. Turnover, Colonials. 55 seconds to go.
the lead, 61-59. We're here for the boys' basketball game between the Western Wildcats and the Acton Boxborough Colonials. Acton Boxborough comes into tonight's game after two tough losses in their first two games against Westford and last Friday evening against Bedford. They played very well in the first half of the Bedford game and had a double-digit lead, only seen it evaporate. And they had to come back with some late game heroics by John Duclos to tie the game up with no time left on the clock to go in overtime. They then lost the overtime period and lost by 7 to Bedford. Western's got two low ball scholastic football players in the starting lineup in Cy Butler and Keith Mohammed. They also have ML Carr's son, Mike Carr, the starting sophomore guard for Western. For Acton Boxborough, got Trey Gullich, D. Thomas, Colin Brandon, John Duclos, and Michael Dean. Got John Duclos in the starting lineup again, but he's in the place of D. Thomas. Turnover for Jim D. A little ragged to start. Got a defensive team in the league. They're really playing tough right now. John Duclos. Yes, big basket. Needed that one. Trey Gullich. Yes, Gullich. 9. Gullich, basket hanging. Basket. Nice play, Jimmy D. 16-11. Good work by the Colonials. Nice look.
Haven't been able to make it.
Nice, John Duclos all the way.
Hang.
Take him. That's it. Nice look. Way to go.
All right. D. Thomas with the block. Picked the block off the floor and made it. Strong move by Michael Dean.
Just got blocked. Nice look, John Duclos. Yes! Matt Tchaikovsky from D. Thomas. 1 point game. Mike Carr in for Weston. Brandon, D. Thomas. D. Thomas wide open and hits it. Basket, Colin Brandon. Nice try. The end of the first half. Weston, 35. Acton Boxborough, 26. Here for second half action at Weston High School for the boys basketball game between the Weston Wildcats and the Acton Boxborough Colonials. The score at the end of the first half again is 35-26, Weston over AB. Scoring summary for the first half: Jim D with 4 points, Matt Tchaikovsky with three, Colin Brennan two, D. Thomas 6 points off the bench and a nice outing for the sophomore, John Duclos with five, Trey Gulledge with six. Michael D has been shut out in the first half. He did get in the game. D. Thomas, though, has four fouls. Matt Tchaikovsky with three. D. has one. Colin Brandon, two. Michael Dean, Duclos, and Gowitz, one each. For Weston, they were led by Dwayne Simmons with 12 points. Keith Muhammad, five. Peter DeLee, three. Mike Carr had five. Cy Butler, four. Ari Scolamario, two. Kaj Edison, four. Story was not Dwayne Simmons, even though he had four fouls. The story of the first half was the guard play of Weston. Cy Butler and Mike Carr had a fabulous first half defensively and with a number of nice assists off to Muhammad and Simmons. Very fast team, Weston, playing very well defensively. A good transition team. See about getting Mike Dean off here a little bit. Balls to Mike Dean. Yes, Michael Dean. Yes, for two. D. Colin Brandon, Jim D, John Duclos, Michael Dean for two. Mike Dean off quickly in the second half. 35-30. They're going to need him if they're going to come back. Up and running. Rebound. Michael Dean for three. Needed that one. Nice job. He was wide open. Needed to take that. Cy Butler. Big rebound. Dean again. Outlook to Gulledge. Yes! Gulledge with the step. Yes! Time is closed to within one, 37-36. 12.
59 to go.
Ball's into Dean.
Yes, Michael Dean on the give back from Gullidge. Colonials by one.
Take that open three. Giving them that if they want it. Don't want it though. Butler.
Rebound, Duclos.
Nice job, John Duclos.
Jim D. Duclos, nice fight.
Both teams playing hard. Both teams playing hustle. Hustle ball. Michael Dean.
Yes, Michael Dean. Michael Dean, 8 points in the second half. AB by one.
Colomero, downtown.
Way B back down by four. Weston up 48-44.
Down by four. Nice basket back at you, Wayne Simmons. Nice assist from Mike Carr. Six points.
27 seconds to go. AB's substituting. Greg Loser, Mike Finn getting their first time of the year. Greg Robideau also in the game for AB. 21 seconds to go. Butler, 10 seconds. Simmons. There it is. Final score, Weston 56, AB 46. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Acton Box High School for the boys basketball game between the Acton Boxborough Colonials and New South Lions. It's Wednesday evening, December 23rd, 1992. AB comes into this game 0-3 in league play, 0-3 overall. New South comes in 2-1 overall, 2-0 in the league, one of the better teams in the league. Jumping center for New South is Paul Krasinski. Seems like it's about the ninth year in a row that there's been a Krasinski on this team. Krasinski goes about 6'7", so again, we're giving away a lot of height. Ball's over to John Duclos. Starters for Acton Boxborough. Duclos, Brandon, D. Thomas, Gullidge, and Michael Dean. New South's only loss is against the Catholic Memorial, which is no disgrace. Again, one of the better teams in the Dual County League. Colin Brandon. Nice hustle, D. Thomas. Ball's off of D. Thomas. New South ball. Has 9 players dressed this evening. They have a couple players hurt, evidently. But also, they've played very well in the early season. And Paul Krasinski in the middle is only a junior. Very, very big, very good in the low post. Nice rebound, number 33. Fakes it. Denny Nobbin. Over the top of Michael Dean. Man-to-man defense. Man-to-man for Newton South.
Newton South, man-to-man on the inbound. Michael Dean. Sophomore Jamel Green playing the point, playing Brandon. Steal. Gullidge in the corner. Yes, Trey Gullidge. AB's on the board. 7-2. This is something new. A Newton South team that shoots from outside. Well from outside. 10-2. Newton South over AB. They keep hitting that outside shot. They're going to be tough. Colin Brandon. Yes, Michael Dean. Rolls around and around and goes through. 14-6. 10-15. That's it. Yes. Colin Brandon to Trey Gullidge for two.
Chikowski.
Chikowski, nice move, Matthew.
Michael Dean.
Colin, yes, Colin for three. Steal, Jim Dean. Yes, Jim Dean.
Did a nice job inside. Michael Dean, yes. 8-point lead, Newton South. Newton South picking the defense up. Michael Dean.
Fouls on Dean. His second. 33, Denny Nobby back into the game.
Vonderlin is making his presence felt. Yes, good hustle.
2 zone for the Colonials.
Nobby looking to the basket. Every turn. Inside. Jump ball. Possession arrow back to AB.
Good job, John Duclos.
Throw his weight around a little bit. Michael Dean. Yes, for two.
Yeah, air ball.
Eric Vonderlinen's having himself a nice night. Forced it. Jim D.
Yes, for three. Jim D playing with a lot of confidence. 29.
He's walking. Yeah, another block. Duclos. Good defense, Dean and Duclos.
41, Amani Allen and a block. Yes, D. Thomas. Nice block, Trey Gullidge. Layup, D. Thomas. 32-27. We got 8 seconds to go. Newton South ball on the side. Find the shooters. To walk. Newton South only had 4 fouls the whole half. AB only had 6. With Stuart Feinberg, that's usually what happens. They let him play. 32-27 the score at the end of the first half. Stand by for second half action. playing. Michael Dean still playing hard. To the turnover. Mike Finn into the game. Mike Finn, number 32, win for Akron Boxborough. Get in, nice shot. That was Amani Allen, I believe. 80-49. Michael Dean. D. Thomas missed it. Nice rebound, Micah Hauben. Job. Michael Dean short. Michael Dean out of the game with 20 points. Points in the second half for Michael Dean. 2:33 to go. Trying to get a double. Mike Finn. Micah Hauben. Pushed off. 50. On the line. AB ball. 142.
Foul. seconds left on the clock. Acton up by five. Michael Dean going to the line for a 1-1. That was a big basket by D. Thomas. Sorry, he gets another one now. Violation right there.
Basketball. It's Friday evening, January 8th, 1993. We're here for the boys basketball game between the Acton Boxborough Colonials and the Concord Carlisle Patriots. Eric Vonderland in jumping center against Chris Anderson. Sophomore against the center. Against the senior. Vonderland gets the initial tap. Then to John Duclos. Michael Dean, man-to-man for the Patriots.
Foul. No, 3-point.
For Gullidge, 24-19. Fivik. Nice play, John Duclos. Yes, steal! Yay! Third foul! Third foul on Anderson! Free on Chris Anderson. Nice job, Trey Gullidge. Go. Getting to be kind of a grinder here. Surrounding Chris Anderson. Wide open. Yes! Trey Gullidge for two. 2-point game. Timeout, Concord Carlisle. Six to go. Concord Carlisle 24, Acton Boxborough 22. Good shot here, guys. Down by two.
Here it is. Here it is.
Yay, Michael Dean. Nice. Gullidge. Yes, for two. Tie ball game. 26 up. Colonials with a chance to advance for the lead. D. Thomas. Yes! Two. Charge. Fouls on Brandon. Three again. Hit one. Big basket, Chris Barton. Chris Barton. Basket. Keenan Smith. 6-point lead. Game, 2 minutes and 12 seconds ago. Game was on the line, they just came to play here at the end.
Michael Dean from three. 6-point game, 30 seconds to go. Double dribble. AB ball, 25 seconds to go, down by six. Need a little bit of luck here, or maybe a lot of luck. 25 seconds to go. D. Thomas, no, long. Tried to give a foul, couldn't give one. January 10th, 1993, and we're here for the basketball game between the Malden Catholic Lancers and the Acton Boxborough Colonials. Von der Linden, 6'7" sophomore, jumping center against number 30, Bill D'Agostino. Ball to Malden Catholic. Over to 10, John Leo. He's been there forever. Acton Boxborough traffic, D'Agostino, blocked by Ivan von der Linden.
Ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Acton Boxborough Boys Basketball. This is Tuesday, January 5th, 1993. I'm John Duclos, and we're here at Acton Boxborough Regional High School for an afternoon boys basketball game between the Acton Boxborough Colonials and the Wolfpack of Boston Latin. Over to Michael Dean, over to Colin Brannon. Colin's shot is good.
Thomas getting the rebound. Yeah, 2 points. Good basket by Trey Gullis. Shooting 8:14 to go in the first half. 18. Poke away by John Duclos. Great defensive work by Duclos. Fouled by Uchina, the lat. That's his first foul. Colin Brandon in for Trey Gullis. Great work by Trey Gullis. Great work on the boards. Over to D. Thomas. Colin Brandon now has the ball. Man-to-man defense by Latt. Michael Dean. Score tied, 20-20. 7:47 to go in the first half. Good ball, good ball handling by Acton. Good assist, good luck. 22 to 20. Good look by Duclos into D. Thomas. Acton up by four now, 24-20. 7 minutes to go in the first half. Acton still in extended zone. 1-2-2 extended zone. Duclos with the rebound. Over to Michael Dean. Michael Dean pushing the ball up. Over to Jimmy D for three. Jimmy D, three-pointer. Acton up by seven now, 27-20, with 6.5 minutes to go in the first half. Mike. D. Thomas with a jumper from the foul line.
Ball back out.
Three-point shot by Jimmy D is good. Acton up by 10 with less than 5 minutes to go in the first half, 32-22. Michael Dean's three. Foul inside. Good rebound by Trey Gullis and got fouled.
Michael Dean's three-point
attempt is good. At the end of the first half, Acton Boxborough 40. Boston Latin 27. Still, man-to-man defense by Boston Latin. Jimmy D inside. Good for two. Jimmy D took it right to the hole and scored two. John Duclos with a loose ball over to Jimmy.
steal on that pass. Over to Jimmy D. Jimmy D's basket is good. Timeout called by Latt. With 14 minutes to go here in the second half, Acton's lead is back up by 16 points. The Colonials 48, and the Wolfpack has lost in Latt 32. Gullidge, over to John Duclos, over to Colin Brannon. We got a foul. Foul on Walsh for Latin. On a grab. Colin Brannon's going back to the line to shoot 1-1. This is Doug Walsh's first foul in the game. 1-1 for Colin Brannon. Basket's good. Lead back up to 6 now. 30 seconds to go in the game. Collins has a second shot. Sinks the second one. Back up to a 7-point lead here. Acton playing a 1-3-1 zone defense. Ball again. 18 seconds on the clock. Over to Trey Gullidge. Over to Trey Gullidge, over to John Duclos, Colin Brannon. Got a foul called on Walsh in the backcourt. 7 seconds left in the, 9 seconds left in the clock. And Colin Brannon is going back to the line for 1-1. Shot good. We're down a 2-point lead, and that's the game. The final score, Acton Boston 75. Sudbury Regional High School for a boys basketball game between the Colonials of Acton Boxborough and the Lincoln Sudbury Warriors. Jumping for Lincoln Sudbury will be Matt Williams at 6'6", and at 6'6" for Acton will be sophomore Eric Vondelin. Michael Dean, Jimmy D with a three. That basket's good.
Matt Williams.
D. Thomas with the steal. Tip in by Eric Vondelin and is good. Play. 1 minute and 20 seconds to go here in the first half. Still a 5-point lead for Lincoln Sudbury. A charging foul calling Colin Brannon. Sudbury up by 7. Trey Gulledge in the corner. John Duclos' follow-up, tip in by Eric Vondelin. 10 seconds to go, Sudbury up by 5. They'll be playing for the last shot.
Oh, no.
That's the end of the first half. Lincoln Sudbury, 25, Acton Boxborough, 20. Stand by for first half statistics and second half action. Jimmy D with the ball. Over to D. Thomas. D. Thomas is good. Nice corner runner by D. Thomas is good. First 2 points for Acton here in the second half. Matt Williams shot it. Short. Rebound by Trey Gulledge. Over to Michael Dean. Matt Jankowski's basket is good. Matt Williams left unguarded underneath. Got an easy 2 points. 37-24. Lincoln Sudbury lead over the Colonials of Acton Boxborough. Michael Dean with the ball. D. Thomas from the corner. Let's put the ball now for Acton. Matt Jankowski. Scores from the corner. 45. Lincoln Sudbury. 29. Acton Boxborough. 8.5 minutes to go here in the second half. Block. Michael Dean's pass. 3-pointer is good. Sudbury up by 18. Michael Dean's 3-point is good. Greg Robito is it for D. Thomas. Greg Lozier's shot. Good. Greg Lozier's good for his shot. 50-37. Nice play. Nice play by Jimmy D. Over to Eric Vondelin. Eric Vondelin with a rebound. Greg Robito with a rebound again. That's the end of the game. Final score. Lincoln Sudbury 56, Acton Boxborough 43.
Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to Acton Boxborough High School for the boys' basketball game between the Acton Boxborough Colonials and the Wayland Warriors. It is Tuesday afternoon, January 19th, 1993. Wayland comes into this game with a 4-6 overall record, 1-6 in the dual county league. Acton Boxborough is 2-7 overall with a 1-6 record in the league. Duclos, Trey Gowitz, Colin Brandon, and Michael Dean. For Whalen, number 50. Tyler Post, jumping center against Vondelin. Whalen with the tap. Brendan Burke. Number 12, Mike Perlman. Number 15, Scott Watt. Back to Perlman. Blocked by Brandon. Last. Michael, no, Trey Gulledge inside, I believe. 6-2. Gulledge from the side. Yes, Trey Gulledge. 14:05 to go. Whalen's up 6-4. Long. Basket, Gulledge. 6 points, I believe, for Trey Gulledge now. 8-6, 13-20. For the Gulledge. Back to Duclos. Von der Linden with the rebound. Kevin alive. Brannon. Yes, for three. AB up 9-8. Dean. Jim D all alone. Three, Jim D. Nice assist, Michael Dean.
Burke doing a nice job on Dean.
Nice move, Jim D. Good look, Michael Dean.
23-15.
Greg Loser into the game. Jim D downtown. He got killed. They didn't call it. Shoots it again. Yes, three. Jim D with 8 points off the bench. Three sophomores, a junior and a senior on the floor for AB. Nice play. John Duclos. And the foul. Chance for a three-point play.
D. Thomas.
Zone still. D. Thomas. Missed it. Yes, back up and in by Matt Chakowski. That's a walk. Steal Lozer. Nice job. Michael Dean. Michael Dean. First bucket for Michael Dean, 26-24. AB only down two now.
Excited the last time out. He wanted a little more intensity.
Maddie Thomas, and we're tied. 26 up, 3:26 to go. Nice comeback by AB. I believe it's a 12-2 run here by AB.
29-26,
Whalen up by three. Chakowski for three. Yes. No, he only gave him two. Said he was on the line, two.
Gotta look inside once in a while.
Rebound Lavin. Scott Watts. Colin Brandon, a little bit sensitive. Fouls on Colin Brandon.
11.
Four. Basket, Brendan Burke. Good hustle, Brendan Burke. Score at the end of the first half. Whalen 37, Acton Boxborough 28. Greg Loser. Thomas, Jim D. Nice play, D. Thomas. Got three sophomores. Four sophomores and a junior. Turnover. Oh, wow. I think that was a guess. 37-30. 15:24 to go. Jim D, Duclos, John Duclos, D. Thomas, and did I say Greg Loser? I think that's five. Von der Linden, they have changed the shot. He still made it. Bernardo with the basket. 39-30. Scoring summary for Whalen in the first half. Brendan Burke had 11. Mike and Scott Watts with 8. Mike Perlman with 5. Hitting from the outside for West for Whalen. Run. 11-3.
13:45 to go, 41-37. Nice job, Jim D, with 5 points right off the gun here in the second half. D. Thomas from Jim D. Brannon. 3 for Colin Brannon. Boker, big drop. Chukowski, 3. 14-point game. 63-47, 3:31 to go. Michael Dean for 3. Yes. Nice touch, Michael Dean. AB down by 13. Steal D. Thomas. Basket, D. Thomas. Got flashes of brilliance. 11-point game. Whalen Coates got his starters back at the scorer's table to get him back in. He's seen enough. Whalen's only up by 12-point game. Michael Dean. Rebound. Steal. Nice job, Duclos. Get it to him. Duclos. Yes! 2, John Duclos. 10-point game.
12, 2:25
to go. Dean. Yes, for 3. Michael Dean getting hot at the end. A walk. 9-point game. Man to man on the inbound. Ball's into Burke. Steal. No. Oh, I missed it. Steal, AB. D. Thomas. AB down by 7. Foul, Jim D.
11-point lead. Michael Dean, way off.